بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, after praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى and sending the salutations upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam, and upon his family and his companions, and upon all those who follow, upon his guidance to the establishment of the last day, to proceed, ikhwan, fa subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal alimul hakim. Glory belongs to you, ya Allah. Verily we have no knowledge except that which you have taught us. And indeed, you, ya Allah, you are the all-knower and the all-wise. You are the all-knower and the all-wise. Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min ilmin la yinfa' wa min qalbin la yakhsha' wa min nafsin la tashba' wa min du'a'in la yusma'. Verily, ya Allah, we seek refuge with you from knowledge that has no benefit, and from a heart that has no fear, and from a soul that has no satisfaction nor contentment, and from a dua that goes unanswered, and from a dua that goes unanswered. To proceed, ikhwan, فَنُوَاسِلُ مَعْكُمْ بِهَذِي الْيَوْمِ الْمُبَارِكِ عَوْنًا مِنَ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ ذَكِرَ النَّفْسِ وَيَاكُمْ. So we continue, ya ikhwan, in this blessed and noble night of ours, seeking the aid and the assistance of our Lord, the most merciful and the most compassionate. Dhakira nafsi wa iyakum, reminding ourselves firstly, and our brothers and our sisters secondly, fi hadhihi al-silsila fi bayani sifati salati nabiyya alayhi salatu wasalam li talabi al-ilam, li talabi al-ilam. As we continue in this series of classes of ours, whereas we're clarifying and illustrating the prayer of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam for the student of knowledge, for the student of knowledge. فَانْتَهَيْنَا مِنْ بَابِ إِلَىٰ أَيْنَا تُرَفَعُ الْيَدَانِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ تُرَفَعُ الْيَدَانِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ. So we have completed, bihamdillah, the chapter of where are the hands placed in the prayer. فَانْتَهَيْنَا بِهَذَا الْبَابِ. So we have completed that chapter. وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. قَالَ الْإِمَامُ أَبُو الْعَزِيزِ حَسَنٍ بِنْ نُورٍ حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْ كُلِّ سُوءٍ وَمَكْرُوهٍ. So the Imam, the author, our Shaykh, أَبُو الْعَزِيزِ حَسَنٍ بِنْ نُورٍ مِنْ تَلَامِيذِ الْإِمَامِ مُقْبِلِ بِنْ هَادِ الْوَادِعِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ, who is from the students of the great Imam Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i, may Allah have mercy upon him. He continues, Babu ma hukmu wadi'i al-yadi, ma hukmu wadi'i al-yadi al-yumna al-yusra fi al-salah wa ina tuda'. So he says, chapter regarding the ruling on placing one's right hand upon the left hand in the prayer. وَإِلَىٰ أَيْنَ تُوضَعُ, and where are the hands exactly placed. فَبِهَذَا الْبَابِ, so يُبَيِّنُ الْإِمَامُ الْمُؤَلِّفُ حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى حُكْمَ وَضِعِ الْيُمْنَى عَلَى الْيُسْرَى فِي الصَّلَاةِ وَهَلْ هَذَا مِنَ السُّنَّةِ أَوْ هَذَا مِنَ الْبِدْعِ أَوْ هَذَا مَكْرُوهٌ وَمَا حُكْمُ هَذَا الْفِعْلِ وَمَا حُكْمُ هَذَا الْفِعْلِ. So in this chapter, ya ikhwan, the author, our Shaykh, is going to illustrate to us the ruling on placing one's right hand upon the left hand in the Salah. And is this from the Sunnah? Is it an innovation? Is it hated? What's the ruling on placing one's right hand upon the left hand in the prayer? قال الإمام الرحيم حفظه الله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اختلف أهل العلم في ذلك. So our Shaykh, may Allah preserve him, he says, the scholars of Al-Islam, they differ in this regard. فقال فذهب الجمهور إلى استحباب وضع اليد اليمنى على اليسرى في الصلاة. He says the first opinion in this regard, regarding placing one's right hand upon the left hand in the prayer, is that it is recommended. Is that it is recommended. وقال هذا هو مذهب الجمهور. And he says this is the madhab or the position or the point of view of the majority of the people of knowledge. وَبَيَّنَّا لِأَنفُسِنَا قَبْلُ يَا إِخْوَانَ أَنَّ مَعْنَى الْجَمْهُورِ يَحْتَمِلُ أَمْرَيْنِ يَحْتَمِلُ أَمْرَيْنِ. And we mentioned previously, يا إخوان, that the meaning of the word جَمْهُور, it carries one of two possibilities. That the meaning of the word جَمْهُور, that it has or it carries one of two possibilities. وَأَمَّا الْإِحْتِمَالُ الْأَوَّلُ فَهُوَ الْأَكْثَرِيَّةُ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلَمِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلَمِ. As for the first opinion or possibility, when you hear the word جَمْهُور, is that it means the majority of the people of knowledge. The majority of the people of knowledge. وَأَمَّا الْإِحْتِمَالُ الثَّانِي. As for the second probability, is that it is al-aktariyatu min a'immati al-arba'a, min al-a'immati al-arba'a, is that it is the majority or the greater number from the four imams.
Idha thalathatun minhum yuwafiquna hukman ala mas'alatin ma wa anfarada wahidun minhum fal jamhur ma dhahaba ilayhi هؤلاء الثلاثة.
For instance, if from the four imams, three of them have one opinion, and the other remaining one is alone regarding the ruling of an affair, then you can say the jamhur is such and such. Meaning, from the four imams, the majority of them say such and such.
فقال الإمام هنا فذهب الجمهور إلى استحباب وضع اليد اليمنى على اليسرى في الصلاة.
So as for the first opinion, he says the majority of the people of knowledge have the opinion that it is recommended for the person to place his right hand upon his left hand in the prayer.
قال الإمام واستدل بالأحاديث الدالة على فعله عليه الصلاة والسلام وهي كثيرة.
He says, and they use as their proofs those ahadith that point to the action of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. And he says, and they are numerous.
فمنها حديث سهل بن سعد.
From these ahadith, حديث سهل بن سعد is the hadith of Sahal ibn Sa'd. Hadith al-awwal fi darsin al-an. Uktubu hadha al-hadith. The first hadith of tonight's class. Write this hadith down, ya ikhwa.
فهو من حديث سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه.
It's the hadith of Sahal ibn Sa'd. Sahal ibn Sa'd.
قال كان الناس يؤمرون أن يضع الرجل اليد اليمنى على يسرى في الصلاة.
الحديث وهو عند الإمام البخاري رحمه الله تعالى. He mentions that the people were commanded. انتبهوا هنا. Pay attention here, يا إخوة. That the people were commanded for the man to place his right hand upon his left hand for salah, while in the prayer. That the people were commanded for a man or a woman to place their right hand upon their left hand in the prayer.
وهذا الحديث عند الإمام البخاري رحمه الله.
And this hadith is collected by Imam al-Bukhari in his Sahih.
حديث 740.
Hadith number 740. Hadith number 740.
فبين في هذا الحديث أن الناس يؤمرون في هذا وتعلمنا من أصول الفقه
أن الأمر يفيد الوجوب. أن الأمر يفيد الوجوب. So this hadith clarifies that the people are commanded. And we learned from the science of usul al-fiqh, the principles of al-fiqh, أن الأمر يفيد الوجوب. That the commandment points to or shows that the thing that is being commanded with is obligatory. فإذا المسلم مثلا يجد أمرا من الله أو أمرا من النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام هذا الأمر يدل على أن هذا الفعل ماذا واجب عليه واجب عليه. So if the Muslim finds a commandment from his Lord or a commandment from the messenger of his Lord, then the commandment shows that whatever he is commanded with, يا عباد الله, that this affair is obligatory. إلا إذا جاء أو إلا إذا يوجد آية أخرى أو حديث أخرى يبين بأن هذا الأمر يكون مستحب. Unless there is another ayah or another hadith that shows that this commandment here is recommended. وبدون هذا فالأصل أن الأمر يفيد الوجوب. So without this other ayah or this other hadith, then the origin is that the command from Allah and the command from the Messenger of Allah shows that this action is obligatory. ففي هذا الحديث حديث سهل بن سعد قال كان الناس يؤمرون. So in this hadith of سهل بن سعد, he said the people were commanded. The people were commanded. فمن أمرهم؟ So who commanded them, يا عباد الله؟ النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. They were commanded by the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. قال وحديث واهل بن حجر ابن حجر رضي الله عنه. The second hadith narrated by وائل ابن حجر. وائل ابن حجر قال أنه رأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وضع يده اليمنى على اليسرى. الحديث وهو عند الإمام مسلم. In this second hadith, اكتبوا هذا الحديث يا إخوان. Write this hadith down. Narrated by وائل ابن حجر. That he said he saw the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام place his right hand upon his left hand. Place his right hand upon his left hand. فهذا الحديث عند الجمهور يدل على استحباب. لماذا؟ لأنه من فعل النبي ليس من أمر النبي. So this hadith here, the hadith of Wa'il, according to those who say that is recommended, they use the likes of this hadith. How is that? They say because this is from the action of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. ولا يوجد أمر. And there's no commandment here. فعند العلماء الذين يقولون أن وضع اليد اليمنى على اليسرى على استحباب يستدلون بمثل هذا الحديث. بمثل هذا الحديث. So those علماء who say that placing the right hand upon the left hand is recommended and not obligatory, they use the likes of this hadith, يا إخوان, because it has the action of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. And it has not, or there is not in this hadith, the direct command. The direct command from the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. قال وحديث الثالث. And the third hadith that the Shaykh mentions. حديث جابر بن عبد الله. Is the hadith of Jabir ibn Abdullah. قال مر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم برجل وهو يصلي وقد وضع يده اليسرى على اليمنى فانتزعها ووضع اليمنى على اليسرى. الحديث وهو عند الإمام أحمد والإمام الدارقطني رضي رحمهم الله تعالى. So in this third hadith, يا إخوان, hadith of Jabir, may Allah be pleased with him. He said, مر رسول الله, the Messenger of Allah one day passed by a man, وهو يصلي, and the man was praying while the Prophet of Allah passed by him. وقد وضع يده اليسرى على اليمنى. But this man had his left hand on top of his right hand. This man had his left hand on top of the right hand. فَانْتَزَعَهَا أي النَّبِيَّ عليه الصلاة والسلام. So the messenger of Allah, upon seeing this, took the man's hand and placed his right hand upon his left. فَالْمُسَلِّ كَانَ وَاضِعًا يَدَهُ الْيُسْرَى عَلَى الْيُمْنَى. So the one performing the prayer here had his left hand upon his right. فَالنَّبِيُّ رَأَى هَذَا. So the Prophet of Allah saw that. فَانْتَزَعَ يَدَ الْيُمْنَى وَوَضَعَهَا عَلَى الْيُسْرَى. So the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he saw that and he took the man's right hand and placed the right hand upon the left. And he placed the man's right hand upon the left. قَالَ وَوَضَعَ الْيُمْنَ عَلَى الْيُسْرَى. And then he placed the right hand of the man upon the left. وَهَذَا الْحَدِيثُ عِنْدَ الْإِمَامِ أَحْمَدِ وَالْإِمَامَ الدَّارِقُطْنِي. This hadith is collected by Imam Ahmad and Imam الدَّارِقُطْنِي. فَهَذَا الْحَدِيثُ لا يوافق رأي الجمهور بل يخالفهم. This hadith here does not agree with the ruling of the جمهور here. ما هو مذهب الجمهور في هذه المسألة؟ What's the ruling of the جمهور here يا إخوان؟ الجمهور يقولون أن وضع اليد اليمنى على اليسرى على استحباب. The majority of the people of knowledge, the جمهور, what's their position here? Their position, ya ikhwan, is that placing the right hand upon the left hand is not obligatory. The majority of the people of knowledge, the jumhur al-ulama, their opinion is that placing the right hand upon the left hand is that it is highly recommended and not obligatory. هذا الحديث هنا حديث جابر يخالفهم. But this hadith that they use, hadith of Jabir, in reality, is not a support for them, but rather it's an opposition of their position. كيف ذلك? How is that? إذا هذا الحكم على استحباب فلماذا صححه النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام إذا ليس على الوجوب? If the man was doing something that's an opposition of what is recommended, then why did the Prophet of Allah correct him if it wasn't obligatory? بل صححه النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام لأنه واجب. But rather, the Prophet of Allah is correcting him because placing your right hand upon your left is in fact obligatory. قال الإمام بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The author continues. قال حديث ابن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه. The next hadith that he mentions. حديث عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه. قال رآني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وضعت شمالي على يميني في الصلاة. He said one day, ابن مسعود, he said one day, the Prophet of Allah saw me in the prayer. And my left hand was upon my right hand. فهذا بيان من عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه فانتبهوا. So this is a clarification from عبد الله بن مسعود. So pay attention here. قال رآني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وضعت شمالي على اليمين في الصلاة. He said the messenger of Allah saw me in the prayer. And my left hand was on my right hand. قال فأخذ يميني فانتزعها. وضعها على الشمال الحديث. He said, so he, meaning the Prophet of Allah, عليه الصلاة والسلام, he took my right hand and he placed my right hand upon my left. فنسألكم نفس السؤال الذي سألناكم بالنسبة إلى حديث جابر. So we ask again the same question that we asked regarding the hadith of جابر. إذا عبد الله بن مسعود يخطئ في شيء مستحب فلماذا صححه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ So if Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was making a mistake regarding something that is recommended, then why is the Messenger of Allah correcting him? يصححه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأنه مخطئ في مسألة ماذا؟ في مسألة الوجوب. Because the Messenger of Allah is correcting him. Why? Because he's making a mistake in something that is obligatory. فَلِذَٰلِكَ صَحَّهُ النَّبِيُّ So for this reason, the Prophet of Allah is correcting him. قَالَ الْإِمَامُ هَذَا الْحَدِيثُ أَخْرَجُهُ أَبُو دَاوُدُ وَالنَّسَائِيُّ وَابْنُ مَاجَةُ وَالدَّارُقُطُنِيُّ وَالْبَيْحَقِيُّ رَحِمَهُمَ اللَّهُ He says this hadith is collected by Imam Abu Daud and Al-Imam An-Nasa'i and Al-Imam Ibn Majah and Al-Imam Ad-Darqutni and Al-Imam Al-Bayhaqi. قال الإمام حفظه الله تعالى. So the Imam continues, may Allah preserve him. قال وحكي عن الطيب وحكي عن الحسن البصري وابن السرين والنخعي وابن زبير والليث ومالك وغيرهما الإرسال في الصلاة. So he says, now pay attention to his wording. He says, it has been narrated from Hassan al-Basri and Muhammad ibn Sirin and Ibrahim al-Nakhai and Ibn Zubair and Al-Imam Layth and Al-Imam Malik and other than them, that they preferred that you place your hands to the sides. That you place your hands to the sides. فَنَقُولُ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمْ بِثُبُوتِ هَذَا الْقَوْلِ And we say Allah knows best to the authenticity of this statement being attributed to these great Imams. فَفَائِدَةٌ عَظِيمَةٌ A tremendous benefit. إذا العبد يقول مثلا قال الإمام كذا وكذا أو حكي عن كذا وكذا لا يدل على أن هذا القول صحيح. Just because someone says Imam such and such said or has been related that such and such said is not a condition that that narration is authentic. It's not a condition that that narration is authentic. طيب قال وذهب الإمام الشوكاني وغيره إلى الوجوب He says, and the second opinion regarding placing your hands upon your right hand upon your left is held by Imam الشوكاني ونضيف إلى هذا and we'll add to that وكذلك الإمام الألباني وكذلك الإمام مقبل وكذلك الإمام البخاري وكذلك الإمام الصنعاني وغير هؤلاء بأن وضع اليمنى على اليسرى على الوجوب And we'll add to the Imam mentions al-Shawkani We'll add to that Also Imam al-Albani has the opinion that placing your right on your left is obligatory Also Sheikh Muqbil, the Sheikh of our Shuyukh in Yemen had the opinion that, rahimahullah, placing the right on the left is obligatory. Also Imam al-San'ani, also al-Bukhari, and other than them, also our Shaykh Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Hizam, he has the opinion that placing the right hand upon the left is also obligatory. قَالَ وَاسْتَدَلُّ بِحَدِيثِ سَاهِلِ الْمُتَقَدِّمِ And they use the same hadith that we mentioned earlier. The hadith of Sahil ibn Sa'ad, كان الناس يؤمرون أن يدع الرجل يده اليمنى على اليسرى في الصلاة. And they use the same hadith that Bukhari collects, narrated by Sahil ibn Sa'ad, that the people were commanded for a man or a woman to place their right hand upon the left hand in the prayer. قال وحديث ابن عباس Also in the hadith of Abdullah bin Abbas. And the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qaal that the Messenger of Allah said,
إنا معاشر الأنبياء أمرنا بتعجيل فطورنا ووضع أيماننا على شمائلنا. الحديث ذكره الإمام الطبراني في الأوسط. He says, and the hadith of Ibn Abbas, that the Messenger of Allah said, verily we, the group of prophets, we were commanded to hasten to break our fast, and we were commanded to place our right hands upon our left hands. And we were commanded to place our right hands upon our left hands. قال الإمام هذه الطريق ظاهرها الصحة وإن كانت النفس لا تطمئن لم أو لما تفرد به الطبراني فإن غالبها غرائب ولكن ظاهر الإسناد صحة ولم أجد أحدا تكلم عليها وذكرت الحديث لفائدة. So the Imam, he says, in his checking of this hadith, he says, it appears that it's authentic. He says, but the soul of the person may not feel safe or at ease or tranquil with the narration that is singled out alone, collected by the Imam al-Tabarani. He says, because most of those narrations are strange, meaning the ones that are only found in Imam al-Tabarani's book, and there's no other narration to support it. He says, but that which is apparent regarding this chain is that it is authentic. He says, وَلَمْ أَجِدْ أَحَدًا تَكَلَّمَ عَلَيْهَا. He says, I did not find anyone from the people of knowledge criticizing this chain of narration. وَذَكَرْتُ الْحَدِيثَ لِفَائِدَ. And I mentioned this hadith for benefit. He says, and I mentioned this hadith for benefit. طيب, قال الإمام رحمه الله. So the Imam continues. قال قلت. He says, I say. Our Sheikh, he says, and I say, our Sheikh Hassan bin Noor, the author, he says, وَالرَّاجِحُ مَا ذَهَبَ إِلَيْهِ الشَّوْكَانِيُّ. He says, in my opinion, that which is the strongest opinion is the opinion held by Imam al-Shawkani, that is obligatory to place your right hand upon your left. He says, لِأَمْرِي أَوْ لِأَمْرِي وَلَيْسَ لَهُ قَرِينَةٌ. Now, للأمر وليس له قرينة تصرفه عن الوجوب مع مداومته عليه الصلاة والسلام. He says, because there is a commandment. وتعلمنا قبل أن الأمر يفيد الوجوب. And we mentioned earlier, we learned earlier, that the commandment shows that the thing that the person is commanded to is obligatory. إذا وجد أمرا من الله أو أمرا من النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام عرفنا أن هذا الأمر يفيد الوجوب. So when the Muslim sees a commandment from Allah or a commandment from the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام, this commandment shows that whatever he's been commanded with is obligatory. إلا بقرينة تصرفه إلى ماذا؟ إلى استحباب. Unless there's another narration clarifying that this commandment here is recommended. وبدون هذه القرينة فالأصل أن الأمر يفيد الوجوب. So without this قرينة, without this other narration showing you that it's recommended, then the origin is that the command shows that the thing you're commanded to or with is obligatory. He says, because it has a commandment and there's not another narration to show that this commandment is recommended. Also, because the Messenger of Allah was constant and consistent upon that. وَقَوْلُهُ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. And he also said, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِ يُصَلِّي. من حديث مالك بن حويرث عند البخاري. As he says from the narration of Malik ibn Huwaydith, collected by Bukhari, he said the Prophet of Allah used to say, pray the way you see me pray. Pray the way you see me pray. قَالَ وَأَمَّا مَا نُقِلَ عَنِ السَّلَفِ. فَنَبِهُ هُنَا. Pay attention here, يَا إِخْوَانَ. فِي الدَّرْسِ ذَكَرْنَا أَنَّ حُكِيَ إِلَى الْحَسَنِ وَإِلَى مَالِكِ وَإِلَى اللَّيْثِ وَإِلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ النَّقَعِ وَغَيْرِهِمْ.
أنهم يفضلون الإرسال. انظر إلى ماذا قال الشيخ. We remember earlier we mentioned it has been attributed to the great Imam Malik and Imam Layth ibn Sa'ad and Ibrahim al-Nakhai and Muhammad ibn Sirin and other than them that they preferred placing your hands to the sides. Listen to what the Sheikh says about that here. قال وَأَمَّا مَا نُقِلَ عَنَ السَّلَفِ. And as for what has been relayed from the Salaf, قال فَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِصِحَّتِهِ. He said, Allah knows best. Are these affiliations and attributing these statements that are attributed to them, are they even actually authentic? Did they really say that? Where is the chain of narration that says that Imam Malik said that? Or Layth ibn Sa'd said that? Or are you claiming that the Imam said that? Where is the Adilla that says that? Is it authentic? قَالَ فَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِصِحَّتِهِ. He says, Allah knows best to the authenticity of that. قَالَ وَعَلَىٰ فَرْضِ صِحَّتِهِ فَلَعَلَّهُمْ تَأَوَّلُ النُّصُوصَ الْوَارِدَةَ فِيهِ. He says, and if it's authentic, if it is, then perhaps they are given the explanation or the meaning of those relayed narrations. أو لم يطلعوا عليها. Or if it is authentic that they said that, perhaps those narrations that show that the Prophet of Allah commanded to place your right on the left, or that the Prophet prayed with his right over his left, perhaps those narrations did not reach these great imams. قال فلا يظن فيهم المخالفة مع العلم. Because no one is going to perceive that these great scholars, having knowledge of the Sunnah of the Prophet of Allah, that they would contradict the statement or the hadith of the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. وعلى فرض علمهم بالأدلة ومخالفتهم لها فالعبرة بالدليل. And if they actually said that and the proofs were mentioned there and they opposed that, then the proof is with the Adilla. The proof is with the Adilla. Our beloved brother Abdul Mu'min, he says, Al-Hadithu inda al-Imami Abi Dawud wal-Imami Ahmad ma raqmuhu. What's the narration or the number of the hadith that's collected by Ahmed and Abu Dawud? The hadith is Abu Dawud and Imam Ahmed. The hadith of Jabir is in volume number 3, hadith number 381. Hadith number 381. The hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, collected by Abu Dawud. Hadith number 755. Wa Ibn Majah, wa ahada ashar. And Ibn Majah, 811. طيب قال والله الموفق الهادي إلى سواء السبيل. And he said, Allah is the one who grants success, and he is the one who guides to the straight path. قال وأما أين تدعو فقد اختلفوا في ذلك. He says, next issue. Where exactly are the hands placed? بينا أن اليمنى من السنة أن اليمنى توضع على اليسرى في الصلاة. So he clarifies that the right hand is placed on the left. But where are they? Where are they to be placed? Where exactly are the hands to be placed? قال فذهب الشافعية وداود ورواية عن الإمام أحمد وهو قول ابن زبير وهو قول ابن جري ابن جبير إلى أنها تدع تحت الصدر أو فوق سرة. He says the scholars of the Shafi'i madhab and Dawood and one narration from Al Imam Ahmed and the statement of Ibn Jubayr is that the hands are placed تحت الصدر, just below the chest cavity, just below the chest cavity, or فوق السرة, or just above the navel. ليس على السرة, not on the navel. لا. He says, or just above the navel. تحت صدر, just below, not on the chest. He says, just below the chest cavity. Or فوق السرة, or just above your surra, your navel. Or just above, not on, just above your surra. قال واستدل بحديث هلاب الطائي. And those that have this opinion that the hands are placed just below the chest cavity or just above the navel, they use the hadith of هلاب الطائي رضي الله عنه قال رأيت نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم واضعا يمينه على شماله على صدره في الصلاة. He says, the hadith of Hulab, that he said, I saw the Messenger of Allah place his right hand upon his left on his chest in the prayer. هذا الحديث عند الإمام أحمد. This hadith is collected by Imam Ahmad, وهو منكر. But it is منكر. It contradicts those narrations that are authentic. فيه قبيصة ابن هولب. It has in the chain Qubaysa ibn Hulab. Qubaysa ibn Hulab. Lam yarwi anhu illa Samak ibn Harb. And no one narrates from him except Samak ibn Harb. Qal ibn Madini majhul. Ibn Madini said about him, he was unknown. Kama fi tahdhib. So that man in the chain, his name is Qubaysa ibn Hulab. And no one narrates from him except Samak ibn Harb. And he is unknown. And Qubaysa, Ali ibn Madini said about him, he is majhool. He is unknown. قال جاءت في رواية الإمام أحمد وخالفه. He says it has been mentioned by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, but those that oppose him, they are many. Muhammad ibn Bashar opposes his narration. Ibn Abi Shayba opposes his narration. Ibn Majah, At-Tirmidhi, Ibn Abi Asim, all of them oppose his wording. Yaqub, Ad-Duraqi, Ishaq, Ad-Duburi, Ali ibn Abdul Aziz, Al-Husayn ibn Ishaq, كلهم يخالفونه, all of them contradict his wording. طيب قال فرواه بدون لفظة على صدره. So all of them narrate the same hadith that Hulab al-Ta'i narrates. But in Hulab al-Ta'i's wording, it says على صدره. It says, I saw the Prophet of Allah place his right upon his left, upon his chest in the prayer. Every other narrator narrated the same hadith, but they did not say upon his chest. At-Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Ibn Abi Shayba, Hussein ibn Ishaq, all of them narrate the same hadith, but they did not narrate it with that particular wording. They all narrated it, his right hand upon his left in the prayer, without mentioning the word on his chest. The hadith of Hulab al-Ta'i that mentions on his chest is munkar because he contradicts those reliable narrators, those who are أحفظ منه وأكثره منه عددا, those who are more reliable than him or who are outnumber him in number, they are more than him in number, he narrates it in a way that they did not narrate it and they narrate the same hadith. This is called munkar. This is called munkar. طيب قال فرواه بدون لفظة على صدره ويحتمل أن يكون ذكرها وعدم ذكرها من قبل قبيصة ابن هلاب فهو مجهول كما قال ابن مديني. So they all narrate the same hadith as Hulab al-Ta'i, but he said, I saw the Prophet of Allah place his right upon his left on his chest. They narrate it without the word upon his chest. So the fact that is mentioned from his narration and not mentioned from theirs shows that this comes from Hulab al-Ta'i. And he is just as Ali ibn Madini said, he is unknown. He is unknown. قال وحديث وائل بن حجر. And there's another narration from وائل بن حجر. قال صليت مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ووضع اليمنى اليسرى على صدره. He said, I pray with the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and he placed his right hand upon his left, upon his chest. أخرجه ابن خزيمة والبيحقي وهي منكر وهي منكرة أيضا. And it's collected by ابن خزيمة and البيحقي, and this narration is also منكر. It also contradicts those reliable narrators who narrate the same hadith. قال تفرد بها مؤمل ابن اسماعيل وهو ضعيف وخالف. He says in this hadith of Wa'il, the one who was single in this narration is مؤمل ابن اسماعيل. مؤمل ابن اسماعيل. And he is weak. مؤمل ابن اسماعيل. And he is weak. And many contradict the way he narrated it. From them, Abdul Razak al-San'ani. From them, Abdullah ibn Walid. From them, Abdullah ibn Yazid al-Muqri'. He says, وَهَؤُلَاءِ خَالَفُوهُ مُخَالَفَةً تَامَّةً فِي شَيْخِهِ سُفْيَانٍ. And these three narrators, Abdul Razak al-San'ani, Abdullah ibn Walid, and Abdullah ibn Yazid al-Muqri', they oppose him in what's called مُخَالَفَةً تَامَّةً, a complete opposition, because they have the same sheikh, and all of their sheikh who narrated the same hadith to them was Sufyan al-Thawri. فَكُلْهُمْ سَمِعُوا نَفْسَ الرِّوَايَ مِنْ نَفْسِ الشَّيْخِ. So they heard, all of them, they heard the same narration from the same sheikh, who is Sufyan al-Thawri. وَهُمْ خَالَفُوهُ فِي نَقْلِهِ. But they oppose him in how they, or how he narrated the hadith. He said upon his chest. They said it without upon his chest. Like the hadith of Hulab ibn Ta'i. قال وكذلك عبد الرحمن ibn Mahdi. Also عبد الرحمن ibn Mahdi opposes how Mu'ammal ibn Ismail narrated the hadith. Also وهاشم ibn Qasim ومحمد ibn Ja'far وعبد الصمد وعبد الله ابن مبارك وهم كثير وهم كثيرون. And there are many. عبد الله ابن مبارك. All of them oppose how مؤمل ابن اسماعيل narrated the hadith. قال وطيالس ومعاوية ابن عامر وأسود ابن عامر وعبد الله ابن رجاء وعلي ابن محمد وابن أبي شيبة. All of these great imams, they narrate the same hadith that Mu'ammal narrates, but they don't say it the way he said it. So he makes the infirad. He tafarrada bihadhihi ar-riwaya. He is alone in this narration. So this is called munkar. This is called munkar. قال وقال ابن قيم رحمه الله ولم يقل على صدره إلا مؤمل ابن إسماعيل وكل هؤلاء رواه بدون هذه زيادة. Ibn Qayyim says, so the only one who mentioned upon his chest was Mu'ammal ibn Ismail in this narration. All of the other narrators and the other reports narrate the hadith without the wording upon his chest. قال ابن حجر رحمه الله وهو في مسلم بدون قول على صدره. Imam Ibn Hajar mentions a tremendous benefit. He says this hadith is collected by Imam Muslim in the Book of Salah, but it does not have the wording upon his chest. It does not have the wording upon his chest. وقال الإمام البيهقي رحمه الله رواه جماعة عن الثوري لم يذكر واحد منهم على صدره غير مؤمل ابن إسماعيل. Imam البيهقي mentions a tremendous narration, يا إخوة. You students of knowledge, studying the prayer of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam in detail. Uktubu hadhihi al-fa'ida. Write this benefit down. Ibn Hajar says, Imam al-Bayhaqi says, intayna biqawli Ibn Hajar. We have already mentioned the statement of Ibn Hajar. Imam al-Bayhaqi says that many narrators narrate from Sufyan al-Thawri, and no one from amongst them says that he placed the right upon his left on his chest and mentioned the word chest, except for Mu'ammal ibn Ismail. So pay attention there, ikhwan. قال وذهب الحنفية والثوري ورواية عن الإمام أحمد وإسحاق وهو قول أبي هريرة من الصحابة وأبي مجلس وإبراهيم النخعي من التابعين وغيرهم إلى أنه تحت سرة أو فوق السرة بقليل وعلى السرة. So the second opinion is held by the scholars of the Hanafi madhab and Sufyan al-Thawri, and a narration from Al-Imam Ahmed, and Ishaq ibn Rahway, and it's a statement of Abu Huraira from the companions, and Abi Majlis, and Ibrahim al-Naqai from the Tabi'un, that the hands are placed below the belly button, or above the belly button, a little above the belly button, or ala surra, or upon the belly button. وَاسْتَدَلُّ بِأَدِلَّةٍ مِنْهَا. And they have some proofs also. وَلَكِنَّهَا ضَعِيف. But these proofs are weak. قَالَ مِنْهَا حَدِيثُ عَلَيْهِ. From these proofs is the hadith of Ali رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ. قَالَ وَدَعَ الْكَفَّ على الكف في صلاة تحت السرة. Then he says he placed his palm upon his palm in the prayer beneath or below the belly button. رواه أبو داود. Collected by Imam Abu Dawood. حديث 756. Hadith number 756. Collected by Imam Abu Dawood. 756. وهو ضعيف جدا. But it's extremely, extremely weak. فيه عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق وهو متروك. اكتبوا هذا الاسم يا اخوان. Learn these names. Write these names down. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق. He says he is متروك. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق is متروك. Is to be abandoned, to be left, to be avoided. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق. وفيه زيادة ابن زيد السوائي. زياد ابن زيد. There's another weakness of this hadith. We have عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق and he is متروك. Also زياد ابن زيد and he is مجهول and he is unknown. ففي هذا الحديث اللتان. This hadith has two weaknesses. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق وزياد ابن زيد. Two weaknesses. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق هو متروك. He is to be left. And زياد ابن زيد هو مجهول. He is unknown. وجاء عن علي موقوفا. And the first hadith, Ali is attributing that to the Prophet of Allah. But that's weak. Collected by Imam Abu Dawood. Has two weaknesses. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق. He is to be left. And زياد ابن زيد. He is unknown. فالحديث ضعيف. So the hadith is weak. Has two weaknesses. احفظوا هذه الأسماء. Memorize these names, ya ibadallah. He says, and another narration, Ali, the hadith stops at Ali. He does not attribute it to the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. It is mawquf. It stops at Ali. He says,
أنه كان يمسك شماله بيمينه على الرزق فوق السرة. It says that Ali used to grab his left hand with his right hand upon the wrist. فوق السرة, above the navel. وهذا الحديث موقوف, موقوف على علي بن أبي طالب. This second hadith is not attributed to the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, but rather it stops at Ali ibn Abi Talib. He says that Ali used to grab his left with his right upon the wrist. ماذا؟ Upon the wrist. Above the navel. Above the navel. رواه أبو داود. This hadith is also collected by Imam Abu Daud. Hadith 757. Hadith number 757. First hadith 756, second hadith 757, collected by Imam Abu Dawood. قال وهو ضعيف. He says this hadith is also weak. So the hadith of Ali placing his hands upon his navel and saying that the Prophet placed his hand upon his navel are collected by Imam Abu Dawood, and they both are weak. And the one that is marfu', فيه علتان, the one that they say Ali said the Prophet of Allah used to do, has two weaknesses. Abdul Rahman ibn Ishaq and Ziyad ibn Zayd. Abdul Rahman ibn Ishaq huwa matruk. Abdul Rahman ibn Ishaq is abandoned. He should be left. And Ziyad ibn Zayd is majhul, is unknown. احفظوا هذه الأسماء. Learn these names, يا إخوان. Abdul Rahman, اكتبوا هذا, write this down. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق. And زياد ابن زيد. زياد ابن زيد. عبد الرحمن ابن إسحاق. He is متروك. He should be abandoned. He should be left. And Ziyad ibn Zayd is majhul, is unknown. قال وحديث ضعيف. He says this second hadith is also weak. فيه غزوان ابن جرير الضبي. It has the third name we're going to learn today. غزوان. غزوان ابن جرير. غزوان ابن جرير الضبي. غزوان ابن جرير الضبي. He is مجهول الحال. His condition is unknown. مجهول الحال. وأبوه مجهول. His condition is unknown and his father is also unknown. غزوان ابن جرير is مجهول الحال. His condition is unknown. وأبوه مجهول. And his father is also unknown. قال وحديث أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه. He says there's another hadith also collected by Imam Abu Dawood, narrated by Abu Huraira. قال أخذ الأكاف على الأكاف في الصلاة تحت السرة. He said that he used to place his palm upon his palm in the prayer beneath, below the navel. Hadith 758. Hadith number 758. وضعيف جدا. And this hadith is extremely weak. Extremely weak. فيه عبد الرحمن بن إسحاق وهو متروك. It has the same narrator that's in the narration of Ali that we already learned, عبد الرحمن بن إسحاق, and he is abandoned. قال شيخنا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our Sheikh used to say حفظه الله. قلت. He said, I say. لم يثبت في وضعها دليل. He says, there's no authentic narration that mentions exactly where the hands are placed. He says, فالكل جائز. So all of them are allowed.
لا دليل صحيح يدل على تعيين. Because there's no authentic narration that shows exactly where exactly on the navel, on the chest cavity, two inches below, 2 centimeters above the navel. He says there's no authentic hadith that points to the ta'yin, that shows exactly where the hands are to be placed. We know they are placed upon the right, upon the left. ولكن لا يوجد حديث صحيح يدل على تعيين. But there's no authentic hadith that shows the precision and the exactness of where exactly the hands are to be placed. قال وهذه رواية عن أحمد. And this is a narration from Al-Imam Ahmad. وقال الترمذي وكل ذلك واسع عندهم وهذا الذي ذهب إليه ابن منذر. At-Tirmidhi used to say, all of this is allowed to the scholars of hadith. He says, and this was preferred by the great Imam Ibn al-Mundhir. By the great Imam Ibn al-Mundhir. طيب, فَلَعَلَّنَا نَكْتَفِي بِهَذَا. So perhaps we'll suffice ourselves with that narration or that position, يا إخوان. اليوم تعلمنا حكم وضع اليد اليمنى على اليسرى في الصلاة وأين تضع اليدان. So today we discussed the ruling on placing the right upon the left and the اختلاف of the people of knowledge in that regard. And we also mentioned where are the hands exactly placed upon the chest. طيب ونكتفي بهذه يا إخوان. So we'll stop there إن شاء الله تعالى. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Our brother Kwame, he says, السلام عليكم. I met you in Paris in New Jersey a few weeks ago. It was nice to meet you. Like to get you up my way. إن شاء الله تعالى. Likewise, it was an honor to meet you also, Ya Akhi Fillah. And yes, it'll be a pleasure to come to your community. May Allah honor you and bless you, inshallah. Keep me posted. You can contact me anytime and let me know, inshallah. It'll be my honor to come to your community and meet the brothers there. And may Allah to continue to honor you and bless you and raise you. Wa fa nasabtu fa min Allah. Wa in akhtatu fa min nafsi. Anything that I said that's correct is from Allah. Anything I said is incorrect is from myself. وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.